morning and welcome to Allenhurst Presbyterian Church on this sort of overcast day today. Good to have you in worship this morning. A few announcements I'll make. One is I want to thank our work day workers yesterday. David Lewis, Lana Lewis, Ellie Lewis, Ryder Lake and Star Lake, and Tammy Beasley for helping us with our work day yesterday. We got a lot done with our group. So thank you. Yes?
I would just like to say that the kids did most of the work on the inside with supervision, and I'm very proud of them. They did an awesome
job. They did a great
job.
They did a fellowship hall and the church. They did a great job. A couple of announcements on your calendar there on your yellow sheet. Notice that the women's group will be meeting on Monday, tomorrow at 5:30 p.m. in the fellowship hall. Join them for that, please do. We will have next weekend our Super Bowl of Caring Sunday, when we will be taking up donations, both cash and canned goods for Manna House, as we come together and worship on Super Bowl Sunday. So you see a box in the back, so you can bring in your canned donations and place them in the box in the back on Sunday, and also bring your cash donations for that as well. Tuesday the 15th, we'll be having a Zoom stadium meeting of Savannah Presbyterian, so just be in prayer for the Presbyterians. We meet via Zoom for our stated meeting on that day. That's all for our announcements this morning. Do we have any other announcements I might need to make? Now we can go to our prayer concerns, and I know I've heard that Joanne McIntosh, Nell Easton's nephew's wife, has COVID, and she is in the hospital and not doing well. So please bring in prayer for Joanne and the family. Also, William Harrell, father, has passed. So we need to be in prayer for the Harrell family as well. Other prayer concerns we might have?
I don't have a prayer concern, but I have a joy.
Okay.
Lori starts a new job tomorrow.
That's great. That's right. Lori's starting a new job tomorrow, so we'll pray for her as she begins her new job tomorrow.
Excuse me, but how is your son? He's waiting. He got COVID and had to postpone it, but he will be having it on the 22nd of February.
So we need to still be
praying. Still praying for mom, yes.
Yeah, 22nd of February. That's good to have that date.
And I just want to thank everybody so much for all your prayers. It meant a whole lot, and it's helped, and still have a lot of doctor's appointments and some recovery still to do, but doing much better, and I know it's the Lord doing it.
I know you, and it's great seeing you and having you in worship today.
Thank you.
And also have Natasha with us today. It's good to have you with us today. Any other prayer concerns? If not, then let us go to the Lord in prayer. Let us pray. Gracious and loving Lord, we thank you for this day, this time to come and worship and glorify you. We thank you for being in each one of our lives, and especially in the lives of those that we love. This morning we pray for Joanne as she is in the hospital, and pray for her, and you give her comfort in this difficult time, and be with her family as they stand beside her. Pray for the Harrell family as they grieve the loss of William's father. Pray joys for Lori and her new job, and we pray that you'll give her strength and comfort as she begins that job. And I pray for Ronnie as he looks toward his surgery. Give him courage as he does so. And we do thank you for Jan's continued recovery. Pray continued healing for her as well. And what a joy it is to have her with us today. Thank you for walking with us, for being here with us right now, in this place, in this moment. We're so happy and joyful that we get to come today, meet you, and worship and glorify. now invite the children up front for a moment of children's church. So today we're going to hear about a story in the Bible where this man Simon was fishing, and he had fished all day and all night and he hadn't caught anything. And then Jesus said, why don't you try over there on the other side of the boat? That's right. That's exactly right. And he caught all these fish, and he was like, oh my goodness. But you know why he caught those fish? Because he listened to Jesus. And so I see y'all have y'all's Bibles with you today. And you know, in your Bible, you have all these stories about Jesus, and Jesus tells us things that we're supposed to do, like loving God and loving our neighbor. And if we do those things, then things will be great. And so we just gotta listen to Jesus, just like Simon did. Simon listened to Jesus, and he caught the fish. We need to listen to Jesus and do as he says, and things will turn out. Let us pray. Dear God, thank you. Thank you for teaching us. Help us to listen to you so that things will turn out great. We love you, Lord. In Christ's name. Amen. Everybody, we do have communion today, so make sure you got your communion cups back there in the back table, and you can pick them up anytime during the service to be ready for that. And it's always good to also pre-open them a little bit, so you peel off the top layer and then you peel off the bottom layer for the juice part. FYI. All right, let us now come before our God and our King and worship and glorify Him. Now, would you please stand at table and join me in the call to worship. Loving God, we have gathered to meet you.
We have come to listen to you, to seek you, to worship you.
You are the beginning of all things, the life of all things.
You knew us before we were born.
In you we become, in you we live.
Loving God, you are here and everywhere, around us and within us.
You know our inmost thoughts.
In you we hope.
In you we live. Come, let us worship God. Won't you please join me and sing our hymn, Come Thou Almighty King, hymn number 8.
Holy and merciful God, in your presence we confess our sinfulness, our shortcomings, and our offenses against you. You alone know how often we have sinned in wandering from your ways, in wasting your gifts, in forgetting your love. Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we are ashamed and sorry for all we have done to displease you. Forgive our sins and help us to live in your light and walk in your ways. For the sake of Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. Hear the good news. This saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, that we might be dead to sin and alive to all that is good. I declare to you in the name of Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Ourselves like today. We got off the road to come come here to refill ourselves so that we can get back on the road stronger. And then there are some exits, unfortunately, we can't have a good ride because of the devil. Now, the devil has his signs up on the road, and he doesn't come as a person. He comes as these signs. It says, take the next exit. It's easier and faster. And some of us are lured to go off in that exit. But most of us come back if we can get away. But then also we have the roundabouts on the road, the ones that I get lost on every time. And we get lost, you know. But God welcomes us to come back on the road. But our goal is to hear those words, well done. So this song is We Are Travelers on a Journey, and it comes with the tune Beach Spring, which is in the Baptist hymn, not in yours. So, but anyway, I like it, and I like I couldn't find the words again, but the lyrics are very much like I just described to you.
Please join in our prayer for illumination, which is found in your bulletin. Guide us, O God, by your word and spirit, that in your light we may see light, in your truth find freedom, and in your will discover your peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Old Testament reading this morning is Psalm chapter 138, which can be found on page 545 of your pew Bible. Listen now for the word of the Lord. I give you thanks, O Lord, with my whole heart. Before the gods, I sing your praise.
I bow down toward your holy temple and give thanks to your name for your steadfast love and your faithfulness. For you have exalted your name and your word above everything. On the day I called, you answered me. You increased my strength of soul. All the kings of the earth shall praise you, O Lord, for they have heard the words of your mouth. They shall sing of the ways of the Lord. For great is the glory of the Lord. For though the Lord is high, he regards the lowly, but the haughty he perceives from far away. Though I walk in the midst of trouble, you preserve me against the wrath of my enemies. You stretch out your hand, and your right hand delivers me. The Lord will fulfill his purpose for me. Your steadfast love, O Lord, endures forever. Do not forsake the work of your hands. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Our New Testament reading this morning comes from Luke chapter 5, verses 1 through 11. Found on page 58 of your pew Bibles. Listen once more for the word of the Lord to the church this day. Once, while Jesus was standing beside the lake of Gennesaret, and the crowd was pressing in on him to hear the word of God, he saw two boats there at the shore of the lake. The fishermen had gone out of them and were washing their nets. He got into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, and asked him to put out a little way from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowds from the boat. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into the deep water and let down your nets for a catch." Simon answered, "Master, we have worked all night long, but have caught nothing. Yet if you say so, I will let down the nets." When they had done this, they caught so many fish that their nets were beginning to break. So they signaled their partners in the other boat to come and help them. And they came and filled both boats so that they began to sink. But when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, "Go away from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." For he and all who were with him were amazed at the catch of fish that they had taken. And so also were James and John, sons of Zebedee, who were partners with Simon. Then Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on, you will be catching people." When they had brought their boats to shore, they left everything and followed him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks
be to God. Let us pray. Holy Spirit, come, open our hearts and minds to hear this day. In Jesus' name, amen. I love today's gospel reading from Luke. Maybe it's because it has to do with fishing. As most of you know, I love to go fishing. That's probably why for Christmas my mom gave me a coffee mug that says, "Born to Fish," on one side, and had some words of wisdom written on the other. And they say, "Grant me the serenity to accept the one that got away, the courage not to tell stories about it, and the wisdom to know that no one would believe me anyway." Once I started thinking about it, I thought maybe this would be a good coffee mug for someone to have given Simon from our gospel lesson. Because Simon was born to fish. In fact, that's how he made his living. And to be able to do that, you would think he knew what it takes to catch fish. Which means that if he had been trying all night to fish in this one area, he knew that to try some more would be, more than likely, something that wouldn't work. After all, they had already quit. They had begun cleaning their nets. And yet, he had also just heard of Jesus' teachings. Something that I caught in our gospel lesson this morning, I've always thought about this story and thought that him asking him to put his nets on the other side, just came one right after the other. But in between, Jesus sat out in the boat and he taught them. And they listened to him. So he sat in Simon's boat a little off the shore. And he was probably greatly moved by what Jesus was saying. My guess is that some of what Jesus was saying was about trusting God and following him. And so when Jesus asked Simon to try again, it felt like Jesus was personally calling him out from the crowd. And if Jesus was personally calling him out, why not just answer Jesus and trust what might happen? Which, as we know, turned out to be the right choice, as his nets came up full of fish. I believe we too are called in various times in our life to trust God. Answer God's call and do God's will and work in the world. And I believe it happens in much the same way as it happens in our story this morning, where more than often than not, like Simon, we are a little skeptical about what Jesus is calling us to do and if it will even work out. The question is, when Jesus calls us to do something, when we hear that still small voice prompting us, no matter how uncertain we might be, how would and will we respond? And I hope upon reflection, the answer will be that we respond just as Simon did, despite his own skepticism and his own uncertainty, with a resounding, "If you say so, I will." And how do we know Jesus is calling us? I believe we know when a certain door all of a sudden opens. When out of the blue, an opportunity presents itself. When a thought keeps nagging at the back of our minds and won't let go. These are the times when I believe we need to pay close attention. But far too often, even recognizing Jesus' call, we make up excuses, just as Simon tried to do with his explanation to Jesus. "We have been fishing all night and we haven't caught anything." Our excuses tend to come with other explanations. Like, "My plate is too full, I don't have enough time. I'm too old. I'm too young." One of my favorites is, "Someone else will do it." Or, "They will be all right." Or, "I don't know how." Or, best of all, "I'll do it tomorrow." You can add your own saying to that list, but the point is, we all come up with excuses that keep us from answering Jesus' call. There was a cartoon about opportunity I remember seeing one time in a New Yorker magazine, a magazine I used to subscribe to until it started coming faster and more furious than I could keep up with, so I finally just canceled the subscription. But I remember that caption, and so I looked it up online and found it again. And this is what it said. It said, it's a little one of those little New Yorker cartoon things. It said, "This morning, opportunity knocked at my door. But by the time I pushed back the bolt, turned the two locks, unlatched the chain, and shut off the alarm system, it was gone." If we modified our cartoon to our own purposes this morning, that caption might read, "This morning, Jesus called, but by the time I pushed back the bolt, turned the two locks, unlatched the chain, and shut off the alarm system, there was no one at the door." truth of the matter is, I believe that we tend to wall ourselves off from answering those uncomfortable knocks on the door of our subconscious. Those uncomfortable knocks at the door of our life of faith. Those times when Jesus is calling and we keep from any uncomfortable situations with our excuses. Which is all fine and good until we are confronted with the reality of our calling as Christians to reach out and help others, to stand up when we see injustice, and to be a light of hope of those suffering and in need. Because it is only when we see our faith as not only a comfort to ourselves, but also the means through which we might reach out and help others, that we begin answering Jesus' call in real and tangible ways. Jesus helped Simon not only catch his own fish, but he also called Simon to do more, to help others, to bring others to faith and understanding. When he said to him, "Do not be afraid. From now on, you will be catching people." When they had brought their boats to shore, they left everything and followed him. What a trust Simon had. Left his livelihood, left everything he knew to follow Jesus. This morning I pray that you will listen closely to hear Jesus' call to you. That you understand your faith is something more than just being about your own personal salvation, but the means through which you can help in God's mission to reconcile the world back to himself. By reaching out and reaching up and helping others in their time of need, whenever that need might be. By offering forgiveness, by showing mercy and compassion, by speaking out against injustice, by comforting others in their time of need. But most of all, by sharing the good news of the gospel, God's saving grace, especially to those who need to hear a message of hope when they can't seem to see anything but darkness. The truth is, God is still at work in the world, and in each one of your lives. Jesus is calling, letting each one of us know that we were all, in a way, born to fish. If there's one thing all fishermen know, is that you can't catch fish if you don't have a line in the water. Which means we need to be continually listening for Jesus' voice calling us to cast our nets into the deeper waters of our faith, and then answering, "If you say so, I will." In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Jesus does call us to be at work in the world, helping to reconcile the world back to himself, and part of how we do that is by being a church and being a light and being a beacon to others, letting them know this is the place of grace and hope and healing and forgiveness and mercy and compassion. And so come in and embrace those things. And so we come and we give a little bit to help keep that beacon of hope alive, to show our thanks for what God has done for us. So let us come together and bless our tithes and our offerings. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we thank you for this place. We thank you for calling us to be here now, in this time, in this place, proclaiming your good news to all who would listen. thank you that we can come and meet you on a cold Sunday morning, for you are here among us. Most of all, we thank you for your Son. We can't thank you enough, but we try. We bring small tokens into worship and we lift them up to you. And so we offer those to you. I ask that you bless them. May they be used for your glory and in your honor. In Jesus' name, amen. Jesus summons us here, travelers on a journey that lead us to this table, where we come to remember what Christ has done for us, where we come and be renewed and our own calling to listen. To listen to that still small voice that keeps nagging at us. The voice of Jesus telling us to reach out and help others. To live a life of faith and of service. And it starts right here at this table. When Jesus was surrounded by his disciples, giving them instructions on his last night, telling them to keep following, keep coming back to this table, keep sharing this meal, keep calling others to this table, keep expanding this table until it reaches out to everyone. And so this morning, I invite you to this table. This is not a Presbyterian table. This is Christ's table. And all are welcome at this table. You have come from north and south and east and west to sit at this table. So come. Jesus is calling you this morning. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is truly right and our greatest joy to give you thanks and praise. You laid the foundation of the earth, and the heavens are the work of your hands. They shall perish, but you shall endure. You are always the same, and your years will never end. You made us in your image and called us to be your people. But we turned from you, leaving sin and death to reign. Still, you loved us and sought us. In Christ, your grace defeated death and opened the way to eternal life. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with the celestial choirs and with all the faithful from every time and place who forever sing to the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Remembering your gracious acts in Jesus Christ, we take from your creation this bread and this cup and joyfully celebrate his birth, death, and resurrection as we await the day of his coming again. Help us, O God, to love as Christ loved, knowing our weakness, may we stand with all who stumble. Sharing in his suffering, may we remember all who suffer. Held in his love, may we embrace all whom the world denies. Rejoicing in his forgiveness, may we forgive all who sin against us. Give us strength to serve you faithfully until the promised day of resurrection, and with the redeemed of all ages, we will feast with you at your table in glory. Amen. And so it was on the night Jesus was betrayed. He took the bread, and after giving thanks, he broke it. And he said, "This is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And then the same manner, he took the cup. After pouring it, he said, "This is my blood shed for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink this, remember me." As often as we drink this cup and eat this bread, we proclaim the saving death of our risen Lord until he comes again. The gifts of God for the people of God, thanks be to God. So we take the bread from here. And we say, Christ's body broken for us all. And we take the cup and say, Christ's blood shed for us all. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we thank you for this table, for summoning us here today. Help us listen for your voice each and every day. guide us and lead us while we are travelers on this journey. We thank you for walking with us, being there beside us. We pray that you'll always be with us and continually teaching us, as you even taught us how to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now, would you please stand your able as I offer you your charge and blessing for this day. My charge for you is to go from this place and to think how Jesus is always calling us. Jesus is always speaking to us. And we say, well, we don't hear a voice. It's not audible. I don't know what Jesus is saying. But you know what? You do have that little voice inside your head. And you know when it's Jesus prompting you to do something. To pick up a telephone. To go visit. To comfort. Bring food for those in need, to reach out. That's Jesus. That's when we get those thoughts in our mind, that's Jesus calling us to do those things. So we need to listen and then say, yes, I will, Lord. May God bless you and keep you. May God's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord turn his face to you and give you peace. Amen.